So I am singing completely his words. But I think they're great. I think
and what
it's
was
a great
what
song.
Was Dave's response?
He loved it. He loved it. He wrote me back and said, "Wow!" And we made a cooperative agreement that instead of paying each other anything, we each have the right to send copies of the song to anybody to use it for whatever reason we want to. He asked for that. He said, "Could I get some get a download of this and give it out to people for publicity purposes?" I said, "Do whatever you want to do. Can I do the same?" He goes, "Absolutely." So we have a cooperative agreement. And if the unlikely happens and it ends up in a movie or something and any serious money takes place, then we we'll share that.
Yeah. But that's great.
He seems to be a pretty good guy. I've not met him, but I love his song and liked his music when I heard it. So he's pretty
and this
good
is
guy.
On your new album.
Yeah, it's called White Flower. Day was bright and sunny, as most May days tend to be, in the hills of Appalachia down in Knoxville, Tennessee. A dozen men put on their suits and quickly took their places, in white robes and those tall and pointed hoods that hid their faces. Their feet fell down in rhythm as they started the parade. They raised their fists into the air, they bellowed and they brayed. They loved to stir the people up, they loved when they were taunted. They didn't mind the anger, it's exactly what they wanted. As they came around the corner, sure enough the people roared, but they couldn't quite believe their ears, it seemed to be support. Had Knoxville finally seen the light, were people coming round? The men thought for a moment that they'd found their kind of town. But then they turned their eyes to where the cheering had its source, as one their shoulders crumpled when they saw the mighty force. The crowd had painted faces, some had tacky clothes, their hair and hats outrageous, each had a bright red nose. The clowns had come in numbers to enjoy the grand parade. They laughed and danced that other clowns had come to town that day. And then the marchers shouted, and the clowns all strained to hear. Each one tuned in intently, with a hand cupped to an ear. White power, screamed the marchers, and they raised their fisted hands. The clowns leaned in and listened, like they couldn't understand. Then one held up his finger, and helped all the others see the point of all this yelling, and they joined right in with glee. White flower, the clowns shouted, and they reached inside their clothes. They pulled out bags and tore them, and huge clouds of powder rose. They poured it on each other, and they threw it in the air. It got all over baggy clothes and multicolored hair. Now all but just a few of them were joining in the jokes. You could almost see the marchers turning red beneath white cloaks. They wanted to look scary, they wanted to look tough. One rushed right at the clowns, enraged, and was hauled away in cuffs. But the others chanted louder, marching all around the bend. The clowns all marched on to a course, supporting their new friends. White power, came the marchers' cry, they were not amused. The clowns grew still and thoughtful, well, perhaps they'd been confused. They huddled and consulted, this bright and silly crowd. They listened quite intently, then one said, "I've got it now." White flowers, screamed the happy clown. All the rest joined in. The air was filled with flowers, and they laughed and danced again. Now everyone loves flowers, and white's a pretty sort. I can't think of a better cause for people to support. Green flower stems went flying like small arrows from bad archers. White petals covered everything, including the mad marchers. And then a very tall clown called the others to attention. He choked down all his chuckles and said, "Friends, I have to mention that what with all this mirth and fun, it's sort of hard to hear. But now I know the cause these paraders hold so dear." Tight showers, the clown blurted as he hit his head in wonder. He held up a camp shower, all the others all got under. Or at least they tried to get beneath, they strained but couldn't quite. There wasn't room for all of them, they pushed but it was tight. White power, came the mad refrain, quite carefully pronounced. The clowns consulted once again, then a woman clown announced, "I've got it, I'm embarrassed that it took so long to see. But what these marchers march for is a cause dear to me. Wife power, she exclaimed. All the other clowns joined in. They shook their heads and laughed at how erroneous they'd been. The woman clowns were hoisted up on shoulders of the others. Some pulled on wedding dresses, chanting, here's to wives and mothers. The men in robes were sullen, they knew they'd been defeated. They yelled a few more times, then they finally retreated. And when they'd gone, a kind policeman turned to all the clowns and offered them an escort through the center of the town. The day was bright and sunny, as most May days tend to be, in the hills of Appalachia down in Knoxville, Tennessee. People joined the new parade, the crowd stretched out for miles. The clowns passed out more flowers and made everybody smile. And what would be the lesson of that shiny southern day? Can we understand the message that the clowns sought to convey? Seems that when you're fighting hatred, hatred's not the thing to use. So here's to those who march on in their big red floppy shoes.
Rod McDonald live in the WLRN studio. So is that a true story?
Yeah, apparently, yes.
Wow.
And it's also an illustrated book. David Lamont did drawings with the book. It's quite a nice piece of work. You can find it online. I think you can just find it under White Flower, but davidlamotte.com, I'm sure you'd find. L-A-M-O-T-T-E.
Also on Rod McDonald's latest album.
And also on Later That Night, yeah.
Later That Night. Rod is in concert Saturday night at the Lunastar Cafe in North Miami. Rod, thank you so much for coming by.
And October 19 at the Arts Garage.
And at the Arts Garage for opening for Eric Anderson. Rod, thanks so much for coming in.
Great to see you, Mike.
Here's Audrey Auld.